Yet another Obama crony is going down in a humiliating scandal. This time, it's Obama's former entrepreneurial ambassador Elizabeth Holmes, who was forced to give up control of her company and pay a $500,000 fine for perpetuating a massive fraud from town hall. On Wednesday, the SEC settled a lawsuit against Theranos CEO Elizabeth Holmes, forcing her to cede control of her company and pay a $500,000 fine in response to charges that she used her position to perpetrate a massive fraud scheme. The SEC believes that Holmes ultimately bilked her investors out of more than $700 million in return for faulty medical technology and empty promises to revolutionize the healthcare industry. According to the original SEC lawsuit, Holmes systematically deceived investors in a variety of ways. Often, she would make fantastical claims that her engineers had developed revolutionary new technologies and machines, including a mini-lab blood analyzer that would use one tiny finger prick sample to perform approximately 90% of the tests that a large, traditional central lab could perform. This understandably generated not just investments, but a good amount of positive media attention. The Wall Street Journal, Wired, and the New York Times all published glowing articles about Holmes. She was even featured in several laudatory front-page covers, while Forbes show her leading the class of 2014 and Fortune portrayed her as aiming to revolutionize healthcare. Incorporated triumphantly proclaimed her the next Steve Jobs and one of eight women who could own the future. Holmes used this impressive publicity run to further lend credibility to her company and get more investors on board. Her company presented potential investors with binders full of materials that included the positive press pieces as proof of her firm's solid foundation. These binders also showed false financials claiming that Holmes's company was making hundreds of millions of dollars and was on track to eventually reach $1 billion in net revenues. However, the real numbers for Theranos' net revenue at that time were only in the hundreds of thousands. Many prominent people were apparently suckered by Holmes and her company, including high-profile political figures like current Secretary of Defense James Mattis and famed diplomat Henry Kissinger, who even published a short piece for Holmes's placement in Time's 2015 list of the 100 most influential people in the world. In May 2015, Holmes reached the apex of her public legitimacy when the Obama administration promoted Holmes as one of its presidential ambassadors for global entrepreneurship page. The official Obama White House YouTube channel even produced a short video with her. Like and share this video on Facebook and Twitter if you agree. Don't forget to support this channel by clicking on the donation link down below and subscribing so you never miss any of our trending reports. What do you think about this report? Scroll down to comment below. Now, if you are seeking the latest trends in fashion and electronics and gifts and more at the best prices, please feel free to visit www.atthismall.com. Once again, that is www.atthismall.com.